Good morning, Slidell. Today is Sunday, August 29th. It's about 8:30 a.m. in the morning. Just want to give you a brief update on Hurricane Ida and the city preparations for this storm. We're starting to experience the outer bands of the storm with some of the rain bands. We've seen several bands come through this morning, dumped a couple of inches of rain into our drainage systems. They fill up pretty quickly, but they're flowing out pretty quickly, which indicates that the systems are working. So we're not overly concerned about that, but as the day progresses, it's going to deteriorate pretty rapidly outside. So if you need to be out and about anywhere in the community, you need to do that between now and about 9:30 or 10 o'clock. You got about another hour, hour and a half. After that, you probably need to be getting where you're going to ride this thing out, getting sheltered in place and preparing to ride this out, because at about noon, 1 o'clock, this thing will make landfall in South Louisiana as it goes up through the center of the state and makes its curve back to the east. We're going to feel effects of this storm from about 12 o'clock till probably midnight or later tonight, which means that we're going to be seeing tropical storm force winds and some winds up in the hurricane range around 70, 75 miles an hour. Generally not sustained, probably gusting to that, but we will see sustained winds of 45 to 55 miles an hour for most of the afternoon, after about 1 o'clock on into midnight or thereafter. So you need to be getting close to your shelter, getting hunkered down by about 10 o'clock and being prepared to stay in one place. Right now, the storm surge we're looking at, we feel confident that all of our outlying areas, the low-lying areas, are going to get water in the streets and probably under properties that are elevated at this time. But we're hoping and praying that we don't get any homes with water in them during this storm from the storm surge. The rainfall totals that we're hearing right now are 10 to 15 inches. If it falls over an extended period of time, 24, 36 hours, we probably will be okay with some minor street flooding and maybe not being able to get in and out of your neighborhoods for short periods of time. But we're expecting that we will be able to avoid anybody taking on water in their homes at this time. That's our game plan, that's our goal. All of the pumps in the city are up and running. They were manned last night throughout the night. We have crews that are back in place this morning. They transitioned the shift at 6 a.m. and we have new guys in those pump stations running those systems. They will be there until 6 p.m. this evening, at which time we'll have a shift change and put new guys in to man those pump systems. So everything fully operational. Everything in our drainage system is working. We have crews that are on the streets today that are continuing to check catch basins, choke points in our ditches and canals to make sure that the drainage systems are flowing. We're also looking for debris, things that may have been blown down or blown into roadways. We're trying to clear that as much as possible. But the main message right now is within the next hour, hour and a half, you need to be getting to your place of shelter that you're going to hunker down throughout this storm. By about 10 o'clock, you need to be sheltered in place and being prepared to ride this storm out through the rest of the afternoon and into the evening. Today is August 29th. It's the anniversary of Hurricane Katrina. We don't expect this to be a Hurricane Katrina, not for our community anyway. But the answer to the response to that is that be prepared. If this thing jogs a little bit to the east, we could get a lot more weather than we're expecting. If it jogs to the west, we get less weather than we're expecting. But the bottom line is our community will pull together just like we did after Katrina. We'll help each other. We'll work together. And through our spirit and through our love of our community and each other, we will be able to get through this storm just as we did Katrina and come back stronger than ever. So, with that being said, get ready to get into your shelter by 10 o'clock this morning. Get hunkered down. Be ready, because tomorrow we're going to have a pretty good work day. I imagine the tree limbs and branches, debris that we're going to be picking up and cleaning up. Get ready. Help yourself, help your neighbor, help your friends, help your family. Together, we're going to pull through and get this done. The city is ready and available. We've got our first responders. Everybody's got chainsaws on their trucks and our police cars. We are ready to take action if necessary. So this is your mayor, Greg Cromer, at City Hall. We will be here throughout the duration of the storm. I'll try to put out some more videos as we get additional information. But just the reminder, check the catch basin in front of your house. Last thing you do before you hunker down today, make sure it's clean. Get out and get those gutters and those catch basins clean and get back in your shelter, hunker down, and we'll see you on the other side of this thing. So long, Slidell. Have a good day. Good luck.